Hello everyone, and welcome to a hopefully short introduction to my MF run counter. In this video I will go through three things. First off, I will go through the different features of the program. Secondly, I will go through running this program in game, how it looks like with one Mephisto run. And then finally, I will go through how you can install it on your own computer. So if you only care about the installation part, you can just skip to the end of this video. All right, let's jump straight in. So first off, you can see on the front interface here, we have a session timer at the top. We have a run timer in the middle, which is set to zero at the moment since no run is active. We have a run count that counts the current runs you have done, a fastest run, and an average run time. Then in this list here, you can see the previous five runs, and you can also scroll up to see all the previous runs you have done in the current session. Down in the bottom, there is some buttons to control the different functions. We have a start new run, and let me just demonstrate. So start new run, start the count as you can see here. If you click it again while a run is active, it will stop the current one and start a new one with one click. So as you can see down here, it has been locked and a new run has been started. If you just want to end the run without anything else, you can click end this run. Then we have add drop. What this does is it pops up a input window where you can write a drop, and you can it will automatically focus this window, so you can just start typing. So let's say we found a shaker, click enter, and then it will be added to the drops tab, which you can see here that the current run is run 13 and it has added a shaker there. Then we have reset lab, and what this does is if I activate the run and click reset lab, it just restarts this counter up here. All right, I've always, then in the drop tab, you can see the drops that you found in your current session. So before I started, I had found a Lidless and a Mahim Oak, and now I also added a Shaco. If you accidentally added a drop here, you can select it and click delete selection or press your delete key on your keyboard to remove it. In options, you can define hotkeys for each of the commands down here, with the exception of archive and reset that I will go through later, which doesn't have a hotkey. There is also hotkeys for some functions that actually doesn't have a button. And it's important to mention that these hotkeys are system-wide. So what that means is you can use the hotkeys even when the application is not in focus. And let me just demonstrate that right now. So start new run is by default bound to Alt-Q. And if I focus the path of Diablo launcher here and click Alt-Q, you can see it still starts and I can stop it again with Control-W. So these hotkeys work while you're in-game and the game is maximized, which is really, really nice. So you don't have to tap out every time you want to do something. We then have a hotkey for delete previous run, which is default to Control-Delete, which what it does is simply it deletes the previous run. So if I press Control-Delete now, you should see run 15 disappearing. And as I said, so it disappears, and you can do it again, and it keeps deleting the most recent run. Then we have a pause command, which is set to control space, and what that does is it pauses the timers, and then it shows you this big resume button that you can, it's just really to demonstrate that the run timer is paused, and you can either click the resume button or you can press the pause hotkey again to unpause it. And it will also pause the run timer, as you can see here, in case the run is active. All right. Then we have a hotkey for add drop and reset lab. So add drop is hotkey Alt-A, and this means you can also add a drop without tapping out of your game. So let's add Shaco again. And you can see it's been added like this. And yeah. Then we have the reset lab that I already demonstrated, which also has a hotkey to LR. The final hotkey that is called make unclickable, I will demonstrate that when I come to the part where I show the application in game. Then we have some general options here, which the first one is always on top. It's default set to on. As you can see right now, the application stays on top of other windows, but if I turn it off, then it goes behind. So that you can turn off if you don't like it. Then we have tab switch keys global. You can set that to on and off. What that means is that there are by default bound control shift page up and page down. they switch between the tabs in the application. And this is a global hotkey, but if you use this hotkey for something else and want to turn it off, then you can do so here. Just bear in mind that you have to restart the application for this to take effect. So I have not made this hotkey modifiable, so if anyone would like that, just let me know and maybe I can include that in a future version. Then we have check for new version. So every time you open the application, it checks on GitHub whether I have released a new version, and if you don't like that feature, you can turn it off here. And finally, we have something called enable sound effects, which is turned off by default, but you can turn it off, and what it does is when you activate start or end run, it plays a sound. So let me demonstrate that. As you hear there, there was a sound. Let me do it again. So this is just in case you like to have a sound that for you to confirm that you have started a new run. Then you can also add a start run delay, which you can set in seconds to 3, for example. So if I set it to 3, 3 seconds pass before the run is starting. So if you want for some reason to put a delay on that, you can do it here. Then we have profiles, which is something I worked really hard on getting right. So I hope this current version is to your liking. Otherwise, let me know. So what it does is that you can create a profile for your run. You can put in your profile name, and then you can put the run type, which can the target you're running, Mephisto, Chaos, Chaos, whatever, your MF amount, your character name, and yeah, that's about it. I actually don't use this information for anything, so it's really just for your own amusement to add it. You can also leave the fields blank and it won't show anything here. When you first download the application, it will have a default profile with all of these blank, and then you can create a new one by clicking here, and then you will have this profile registration opened up where you can put everything in. And the only thing you have to fill out is the profile name. The other three fields, you can leave them blank if you want. You can also delete a profile, and when you click delete here, you get a pop-up, a warning, are you sure you want to delete? And then you click OK, and then you actually get a second pop-up that says, are you really sure you want to delete? Because you delete all your data permanently, so you have to be really sure. I switch the keys around, the buttons around, so you have to be aware of what you're doing. But I don't want to delete this right now. Then down here you have a session browser that you can use for browsing your past sessions that you have done. So you can choose active session, which browses the session you have here. You can choose profile history, which takes all previous sessions, including the active session, and you can browse that. Or you can browse some past sessions that you have done. For example, if I click this one and I click open, I get this window up here where I can see the character name, run type, act type, MF, some descriptive statistics of the session, and then each individual run together with the drops. In the bottom you have the descriptive statistics for the current profile with a total session time, total run time, average run time, and fastest run time. And then you can see the percentage time spent in run 2, number of runs, and how many drops you have found. If you want to delete a session, you can do so by choosing it first and then clicking delete, and you get this pop-up saying, are you really sure you want to delete? It will be permanently deleted. So that you can do. You can also delete the current active session by clicking that and clicking delete, and it will be permanently deleted. However, you cannot delete your profile history. It will just give you a warning saying it's not possible, because that would be the same thing as deleting your profile entirely. So I have chosen to block that out down here, and you can delete your profile instead. Okay, so let me get to the final button, the archive and reset. So when you have finished the session, you can archive and reset it by clicking this button here, and it will be stored in this list, and the active session will be set to 0, and all the runs will be removed. So let me demonstrate that in a sec. I just first want to show you that when you are closing the application, it actually saves the current state. So when you reopen it, then it will start from exactly where I left it. So you can just close the application when you're finished with it, and it will just open up again at the same place. Okay, so now that I demonstrated that, let me try and click this archive and reset, and I get a confirmation. I click OK, and then it is set to 0, as you can see here, and it is now stored under my profile. Finally, we have the About button. That is just some general information. You can see the Readme file, and you can visit GitHub for potential new releases. All right, well, with that out of the way, let's jump straight into Path of Diablo and show you how this looks in-game. So I'm just starting Glide up here. It takes a bit longer since I'm recording, so please have some patience. All right. Let's go into my character here, all right. So first I want to show you this make unclickable. By default it actually is set to no bind. I have just bound it for convenience in this video to Alt-V, so I can show you what it does. And the reason I have this is, what it does is it actually makes my application click through. So now I've activated it and I've also made it transparent so it's visible that it's click through. And as you can see, I can move my mouse behind it and still click everything I want. So the reason I have this is that Glide can sometimes be a bit weird with the mouse position. So in case you want to have the MF runtimer in this on top of your Diablo, then you might want to have this on so you don't mess up your mouse while playing. I usually put it up here in the right corner, and then I can activate the click-through ability so Glide doesn't mess anything up. And then let's jump straight in. So I'm just going to create a game, and then I usually wait for the doors to open for the game, and as soon as they have done so, I will click Start New Run hotkey, which is LQ. So here we are, the run has started. And I started the timer, and now I just have to try to fit the hole. Alright. Okay, and then we just show it off. So, very awesome drop. So let's say C-Clubs has been the item you were looking for, and then you just lock it by clicking Alt-A, and you can write your item and click OK, and you're back into the game again. So that was super easy, right? Then we can just for show, say now I leave the game, and then I want to start a new run. So I don't actually end the timer since personally, like, that's up to you, of course, but I like to include the real time of my runs, so also the wait time for starting a new run to get the actual time it takes me to do one run. So when the doors open again, I will click Start New Run, and then you can see it's been locked and a new run is starting. Then when you're finished running, you can just click End Run, and then it will stop. While you're in-game, you can also use the pause. In case you, let's say we are running and I just have to go to the kitchen and grab something, my phone rings, or go pee or something, and I can just click the control space hotkey for pause, and it is paused, and you can do whatever, and then when you come back, you can resume it. Alright, so that's it for the in-game introduction. Let me leave the game again, and then I will in the end show you how to download this and set it up on your own computer. So I will close Diablo, I will close the MF Run Counter, and I will just go to GitHub and download the newest release. So this is what you will see, this is the .exe file. You just click the newest one, download it here, and wait for it to download. So then when it's downloaded, maybe actually what I want to do is I want to my downloads folder, just bear with me for a second, and I'm gonna put it in a folder on the desktop. So folder. So I just put it in here because when you run it, it will create a few files the first time you run it. So it's nice to have it in its own dev folder. So then when you open it up, Windows says it protects your PC and doesn't want to open it, but you just have to click more information and then run anyway, and it should start because it doesn't recognize me as a normal publisher. So that's really about it. The first time you start it, it will create a config file, and here it will save the window position and all your options and your hotkeys, so they are saved in between sessions. It also has a version to ensure that the version capability is up to date. Then it creates a profile folder where it stores JSON files for each of your profiles, where it keeps the data for all your runs. So let's say we start this up and I want to make a new profile. So I click the profile registration and I make a new profile and I make some run. Let's say it's chaos and I have 800 MF, and that's really about it. Now my new profile is created and I want to get rid of this default profile, so I just delete that here. And now I just have this new profile, and you can see the default profile is also removed. By the way, you always need to have one profile. If I try to delete this, it says you cannot do it before creating a new one. So you cannot delete the default profile before making a new one. Yeah, that's about it. Then the only thing I want to say is that I forgot to show you that you can actually export your data. You can export it to a text file and a CSV file, and you can also copy to clipboard. So that was just something I forgot to mention. So if we go into my full browser here, I can click copy to clipboard, and you can press Control V to paste it into Reddit or whatever you want to share it with your friends or something. You can also save it to a text file. You get this pop-up here where you can say my text, and it will save it there. And you can also, you can also save it as a CSV file. If you prefer that for storing it on Google Drive or whatever. So the text file simply looks exactly the same as the archive browser, and the CSV file, it looks also very similar. It's just splitting up each drop into a separate tab and then the time into a separate tab here. But yeah, that's really about it. So I hope you enjoy this tool, and if you have any suggestions for improvements or anything that is not working and giving you trouble, then please let me know and I will look into fixing it. Thank you and bye.